Not gonna lie, knew nothing about this film going in. Not a single thing, not a single drop of knowledge. I think I might have watched the trailer once when I was like scheduling this, but I have to watch it because it's part of the Spielberg series that I'm doing. And honestly, I'm happy I watched it. It's good. It's very, very good. I didn't expect it. I didn't expect to like it as much as I did, especially considering it's definitely not my kind of film. But today we're gonna be talking about Amistad. Amistad was released in 1997. It was written by David Franzoni and directed by, of course, Steven Spielberg. Now, no spoilers, but the general idea is this ship gets taken over by white men, and on the board are a lot of black people. And it, in the time period this was filmed, or that this was not filmed, oh god, that this was set in, black people were just slaves in America. It's just true. And so they take them to America, they say they are slaves, but they're trying to, these lawyers are trying to prove that they are not in fact slaves. They are just people that live in Africa, which does not mean that they're slaves, it's just that's where they live. And it's about the battle between them trying to do what's right for the abolitionist cause, while battling these judges and other lawyers who want them to be slaves because it's good for, you know, them, of course. And I gotta say, this movie is a little frustrating. It's frustrating on a couple levels. First of all, it's frustrating because it's so wrong. Like, you're sitting here and you're like, you know, this isn't even relatable to me anymore because, like, I've never thought black people were slaves. Like, I even learning about it growing up, I had a hard time believing it because it just feels so wrong. And here, it kind of exploits that feeling in me where, like, this is obviously wrong. Like, this can't happen. So it was easy to identify with the good characters, but it was really frustrating trying to identify with the villains, which there's always something good about the villains. There's always something that, like, is identifiable between the two that makes villains good. And there wasn't one here. They're just really bad people. Not really a critique, more so than it's a frustration. But also, the choice to so that he speaks Mende, the main black guy, the main slave, I guess, the main ex-slave, it's hard to explain. But he speaks Mende, which is the African language that they spoke in their tribe. And the issue is that for most of the film, they don't subtitle it. They have a translator sometimes, but most of the time you don't understand what they're saying. And it really does rely on them to use facial features and hand gestures to understand what they're getting across. And I did have a really difficult time, particularly in the first half of the film, decoding what they're saying, and that was really frustrating as a moviegoer. Like, one thing that I do want to say is that he has gotten better, Spielberg has gotten better at using this. I think that West Side Story was a really good example of this. They have Spanish in there a lot, and I didn't have a problem catching up and understand what they're saying. But here, it was like, we need subtitles. Like, I honestly think we do need some subtitles here to understand what's going on, or at least have a translator there for more than just the second half of the film. It was really convenient that they were there for the second half of the film, but it'd be nice if they were there for most of it, or at least try to explain to us what is going on. Because for the first hour of this, I'm like, okay, I'm only understanding what Matthew McConaughey is saying. That's it. Like, that's really a problem. And I do say the performances are really awesome. Anthony Hopkins as John Quincy Adams was really, really cool, really awesome. The final court scene is, I love it. It's one of those scenes I'm going to go back and watch many, many times. And I do want to say I love court films. I love films that take place in a court. I love when there's a big final battle, like How to Kill a Mockingbird. I love that kind of thing. I eat that up. I love it. So I was happy to see one here with Anthony Hopkins. That was really cool. And also, Jamon Hounsou, I apologize if I'm pronouncing that wrong, as Sinke was incredible. I don't fault him for not being able to get what he's trying to say across in Mende, because it is difficult. But it was more of a directing writing choice than an acting choice. But I thought he did very, very well expressing what he was trying to say. I thought it worked pretty well. It could have been better, but again, I don't necessarily think it's his fault as an actor's perspective. And Matthew McConaughey surprised me here as Roger. He's my favorite character in this film. He's awesome. I want to watch more McConaughey films. Honestly, I think I might pick him up as an additional series coming up in the summer, maybe, depending on if I have to get a second job to pay for my new car or not. We'll see. But yeah, I really liked his character. I liked all the characters in this film. They were all really, really great. They're all portrayed very well, I think, particularly McConaughey's character. But yeah, the story itself is a little frustrating, a little annoying, and does take a long time. There's this flashback sequence, too, that was really annoying to have to watch. It was just like, I don't get why we're seeing this. There's a lot of moments that didn't have to be there, and it is 2.5 hours long and did not need to be. This did not need to be a 2.5 hour long movie. This could have been 2 hours, and it would have gotten the exact same message across, and it would have been probably better, in my opinion. Maybe I'm incorrect in saying that, but that's my thought. And I do think that as a movie, it does its job. It does its job in saying, listen, this is the historical thing that happened. I don't know how true it all is, but it seems true. And stories about slavery sells. I'm sorry, they do. Like, whenever you have an abolition movie, they do very well. And I guess that's probably why they did this one, particularly in the 90s, to remind everyone, I guess, which I don't know how helpful that is, but I think it did its job in telling us that slavery is wrong, obviously. I think it did a good job in saying white people suck, which is just true. And I liked it a lot. I think it did a very, very good job selling what it was trying to sell. And for that reason alone, mainly, I'm going to go ahead and give Amistad an A-. Have you guys seen Amistad? Let me know in the comments down below what you guys thought about it. I liked it more than I thought I would, for sure. I mean, I wish the first hour was kind of trimmed a little bit, but it's a good movie. I'm glad I own it, too. Like, it is something that I will watch again at some point. Probably not in the background, but I'll watch it, like, actually watch it again. But let me know in the comments down below what you guys thought about it. I really liked it. Please consider subscribing. It's a huge, huge help for me. I really do appreciate it. If you do, if you like what you see, like the video, subscribe. And as always, keep watching movies and television. Stay educated. And I'll see you guys in the next video.